This program is part of WQED's Pittsburgh History Series.
Every year, traditionally on the Saturday after Thanksgiving, there's a bike ride in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, game on.
The route for this ride includes 13 of the steepest hills in and around the city.
You're not even supposed to build roads like this.
Cyclists use their lowest gears and work their hardest to complete the amazing course.
It is astounding how many of them there is doing it, and they all seem to be chugging along, so that's what's impressive.
It's a ride that celebrates our city's terrain.
Completely circles Pittsburgh, hits just every major neighborhood. Like, he really found the steepest, craziest hills.
They call it the Dirty Dozen.
I don't know how he came up with that name.
It's a stupendous bike ride.
I was aware that there was a movie, The Dirty Dozen, with Ernest Borgnine, but I don't think we took it from that.
We'll cover the course. We'll talk to Danny Chu, who founded the ride.
Just because it was a dozen hills doesn't, but why dirty? I'm not sure.
We'll talk to riders.
It was really painful. Every hill was really painful.
I felt horrible.
We'll see what we can see in this city of noteworthy and steep hills.
Every year I hope it snows and it's canceled so I don't have to do it because it's one of the longest days of the year.
It's Pittsburgh and a lot of other stuff is made possible by the Buell Foundation, serving southwestern Pennsylvania since 1927.
It's about 8 o'clock in the morning. People start to gather at the northern end of Washington Boulevard in Highland Park. There's a parking lot next to the Zone 5 Pittsburgh Police Station.
Today is Saturday, November the 27th, 2010. It's the 28th annual Dirty Dozen.
That's Danny Chu, the fast-talking founder, the mastermind, the head honcho of this ride around town.
My lifetime goal is the bicycle ride a million miles. I'm two-thirds of the way there at age 47.
Danny Chu is a renowned bicyclist who twice won the Ride Across America, the RAM. And he started this Dirty Dozen back in 1983 with his brother Tom and two or three of their friends. Now there are close to 200 cyclists every year.
The challenge is to see if you can make the hill. If you can't make the hill conquers you. If you make the hill, you defeat the hill. It's a challenge, man versus hill.
Always got to bring a tall guy. That's the only reason they invite me anywhere.
Trying to conquer the 12 steepest hills around Pittsburgh.
Group from Waynesburg's come in and I met him here, so.
It's a good time. I like to see the local people come out and battle the hills.
I actually live in St. Louis, Missouri.
Coming from Sugar Creek, Ohio.
Washington.
PA?
Yeah.
This guy's a flatlander from Virginia Beach.
Yeah.
I'm from Minerva, Ohio.
We all met doing Tuesday night South Park mountain bike rides.
Yeah.
I saw it on the internet last year, and my friend and I decided to come down here and give it a try.
Because everyone else is doing it, we might as well do it.
Yeah.
The Missouri hills aren't quite as steep. We have some shorter hills.
I just came by to see how many people show up.
Got some friends that are doing it, so I couldn't back out.
Takes over 200 gallons of Gatorade and 150 pounds of bananas to run, and about 500 packages of snack cakes.
Pre-race tequila is about to do.
Anyway, these guys before every race will do a shot of tequila. It doesn't matter what time the race starts.
We have both sides of this truck filled with goodies.
Finally, here comes Steve Cummings. Everybody calls him Steve-O. He's won this race the last 6 years. He lives in Lawrenceville but grew up in the South Hills and works for Howard Hanna Real Estate now, but he still races bikes a lot.
I've been racing for 8 to 9 months straight, so if I win, it's because of that. If I lose, it's also because of that, because I'm tired. I'm either fit or tired, so this is my last race of the year, so hopefully I do well.
It's a rite of passage if you're a biker here in Pittsburgh. Let's do the Dirty Dozen, so this is my first time.
This is my second time.
I've done it in the past a couple times.
9 times.
I did it the last 3 years.
Yeah, I did this one last year.
I know the triumph and tragedy of this race.
Just had a blast.
I've been training for almost 3 months. I have two artificial hips. So if I do it, I'll be the first double hip replacement to do it.
The first time it was like this, snow flurries, 27 degrees. We had 5 people.
This is fine. The first year I did it was 34 and rain snowing, so this is fine.
At the top of the hills, the riders get all sweated up, and then when that wind cuts right through you like a knife, it'll chill you pretty bad. So
that's the only thing I'm concerned about is having the right layers and unzipping at the top of the hills so I don't sweat too much.
I've just added 15 pounds to this entire effort here with all this clothes.
You should have seen the looks I was getting in sheets this morning.
He actually didn't make it as Santa Claus elf, so we decided that biking was the next best thing to wear these kind of costumes.
One of those things, it's not hard to twist my arm to go ride my bike, so.
You get to around hill 8, 9, and 10, and there's not too much left. The legs are pretty trashed.
Yeah, it's great. It's great fun riding through Pittsburgh.
It's a great Pittsburgh event.
I'm hoping I get through all of them.
I love this race, and there's pressure because it's mine to lose, I think, after winning it a couple times.
I wanted to showcase the hills and share these steep hills with my cycling friends. You know, at first I knew everybody because it was just a small group. Now, obviously, I don't know all the 200 faces, but I get stories, and my website helps promote the event.
And at 10 a.m., the pack gets organized, a Pittsburgh peloton, and Danny Chu leads the cyclists out onto Washington Boulevard toward the Highland Park Bridge, heading for the first hill in Aspinwall.
The other thing nice about this event is it combines seasoned bicycle racers that are almost at the professional level to your totally beginning novices. So there's all kinds of ability levels, and this is why we go neutral between the hills.
It's a rolling start, and Danny blows a whistle, and it's neutral till then. Nobody can pass Danny. He blows a whistle, and it's on.
Hill number one is Center Avenue and Gayasuda Street.
It's only about less than 2 miles from the start, so nobody's warmed up yet. The riders are anxious. I blow the whistle at the start of the hill, and then it's every man for himself or woman.
Now, not everybody, but some of these riders are racing to be the first to the top. The serious contenders position themselves at the front of the pack and know who their competitors are.
And what's tough about this hill, because it's the first one, nobody's warmed up. So if you go hard on this first hill, your lungs will really burn and be sore at the top because your lungs are not warmed up. The wind, for the top people are getting points, it almost feel like somebody stuck a wire brush down your throat. It'll hurt that much.
So our camera was on Center Avenue about halfway up the hill. Bikers then went on to the top of Gayasuda, and there Steve-O won, Bob Stumpf was second, and Joe Leidick third. We had a camera ready at the bottom of the next hill in the town of Sharpsburg.
This is the second hill out of Sharpsburg. This is Ravine Street. This first part of the hill is the steepest part.
So you go really hard at the beginning because the steep part's at the beginning, and you hope you don't go too hard that you blow up coming up here.
And you come up here, and halfway up here, you the road sort of bends to the left, as you can see the sign there. It curves up. You actually have a little flat. It curves up to the right, and then the hill goes again, but it's not as steep as this part. You finish up by a cemetery, and that's called Sharps Hill Road, the second half.
And then we get to here where it's not as steep, so you might drop down one or two gears, making it harder to pedal. But you try to keep the same cadence, which means you're going faster. So you're going the fastest you've gone at this point because it's not steep. It's a false flat. I feel like somebody's going to get me because I feel so horrible. I feel somebody must be going harder than this. Somebody must be able to be going faster. I feel like I'm crawling at this point because I went so hard at the earlier part.
Nonetheless, Steve-O crossed the finish line first. His teammate Bob Stumpf came in second again, and Jerry Flug was third on this long hill number two.
It's about middle of the road difficulty, yeah. Once again, because it's only the second hill, it doesn't appear nearly as tough as if it would have come at the end, all right? Because riders are still relatively fresh. But it's medium difficulty.
Medium difficulty. But there's barely a pause before the pack is off to the next challenge, still in the suburbs north of the Allegheny River.
We're in O'Hara Township, and this is the third hill. What's unusual about this hill is I actually blow the whistle on top of a big hill because the riders go down this steep hill, which is Browns Hill Road, and then at the bottom of the hill, marshals have to hold traffic because there's a stop sign down there, and they go straight up the third Dirty Dozen Hill, which is called Berry Hill Road. Riders come flying down the hills at speeds up to maybe 40 or 50 miles an hour. They have to change their gear from the top gear to the lowest gear. Sometimes they'll skip that and they'll have to go back down again, and then it's a sprint to the top on the steep part all the way up there.
How's it going?
You get so much momentum.
I hate the fact that I had to go back down and start over. I was in the wrong gear.
This is actually one of the shorter hills. They can get up it in less than 2 minutes, where the other ones take 4 or 5 minutes to go up.
How's the hill? Not bad. As long as you're in a low enough gear. You come down those hills, and you're in too high of a gear sometimes, and you can't make it. But, okay.
Pain is the name of the game.
How was it?
Pretty tough, but fun.
This hill was won by Mark Nickel, with Steve Owen second and Bob Stump third. So now it's three hills down, 10 to go.
Where are we going next?
I don't know. I'm just back here following. Didn't really take a look at the itinerary.
All right, thanks.
No problem. Thanks, man.
The next hill, combining High Street and CV Road, starts in downtown Etna when you turn right off Butler Street.
This is the fourth hill in Etna, and it's actually the easiest hill of them all.
The bottom is mellow. It's deceiving. At the bottom, a lot of people go really hard, because especially if they don't know the hill, they think it's an easier hill, and the steep part's at the top, which makes it difficult.
This hill's as tough as the riders want to make it, because as you can see, if you take the inside on this hill, it is twice as steep if you cut on the inside, and it's not nearly as steep as if you swing wide, make a longer distance, and go on the outside. Same thing with when the road goes left up there. High Street becomes CV Road. If you hug the inside, it's much steeper, and if you hug the outside, it's much less steep and makes it an easier hill.
This is one of the few hills on the Dirty Dozen with a switchback, and the switchback's the hardest part. It's the steepest part, so that's where you try to make an effort to separate yourself from the group, and then after the switchback, you still have 30 or 40 seconds until the top.
What's nice is you can see the other riders, though, because, you know, the switchbacks, you can look up there and see the other people, or if you're ahead, you can look back and see the pack coming up here. So it's a nice visual hill, if you will, because the switchbacks make nice viewing.
It's surprisingly long. Right beyond where we can see, there's another little kicker. And then the finish is right there. First one across gets 5 points, second one 4 points, third one 3 points, 2-1. Points go five deep on every hill. Most points at the end wins.
When you finish, you can pedal on to Millvale for snacks and drinks. But there may be cyclists behind you still negotiating the switchbacks. And some spectators, like Daniel Bellin and his sister-in-law Beth, are still enjoying the day. Her husband, his brother, is out there pedaling.
This is a nice way to see different parts of the city you wouldn't get out to.
Yeah, but that's actually one of the great things about the race, is that in a normal road race, you see the guys fly by once, maybe twice. But here, because they go so slow, you can go from hill to hill, and you get to see the guys a few times, so that's fun.
The little snack break in the Riverside Park in Millvale is quick. Then you're back under Route 28, and surprise, there's a steep street.
This is hill number 5 in Millvale, Logan Street. It starts out by St. Nicholas Church down there at the bottom. Notice the steps beside the hill. But what really makes this hill tough is that the steep part comes at the very end. At the very end, it's close to a 30% grade up there. And it's the fifth hill. It's really the first tough hill of the day.
Nonetheless, as you might expect, Steve-O tops the hill first, followed by Stumpf and Pflug.
And it's really where a lot of the riders, when they get to the top of the hill, they ask themselves, what have I got myself into? Because they're not even halfway through, and yet they're starting to get tired by here, and some maybe even having to walk that final pitch up there.
Good job, guys. Keep going. Keep going.
It does help to have fans cheering and rooting for you to make the hill, because it's sort of like they're pulling for you too, and you hear the fans yelling, and it makes the hill a little bit easier knowing that other people are hoping that you can make it up the hill.
Come on, guys, paddle, paddle, paddle!
Ten
more seconds, come on!
That was brutal. That was the worst one so far.
Yeah, that was pretty awful. Yeah. It just got steeper.
Yeah.
There were no more gears.
Yeah, right.
From here, you can recover as you pedal onto Troy Hill, where everyone gathers near the top of Rialto Street, often called Pig Hill. It goes down to busy Route 28.
But what's unique about this hill is that the riders go down it before they go up it. So they go down, assemble at the bottom, and then ride up. And because of this, I do heats, different waves, if you will. The first heat are all the men who have scored points up on the first five hills, and the overall winners of previous 30 dozens get to go down, and that's the first heat, the men.
So Joe Leidick takes this one, and Steve-O comes in second.
The second heat is all of the women. There were 15 women riders this year.
And they are an amazing group. There are points for the women on each hill, too. The first place woman here on Rialto is Betsy Shogren, with Gray Patton coming in second, and Nina Wilczek in third.
And then the third heat is everybody else, just goes down and does it on their own.
While all this heated up and down is going on, there's a rare social moment when the riders can stop and talk when it's not their heat.
And we are from the bike racing team Sette Nove.
which is Italian for the I-79, because we all live there, or near there.
And how do you know each other?
Bike riding.
Basically from the Wednesday night bike races.
Yeah, we meet every Wednesday night down at the Oval in the summer and race around fast as we can.
Yep.
We're all old, we pretend to be young.
Yeah.
So the next hill after this, Suffolk, is the single toughest of all of them. So they have to know that the toughest hill is coming up right after this one.
So the pack pedals on to Suffolk on the north side. It starts under I-279 in the old East Street Valley and goes up to the top of Fine View.
I think it's a killer. I think it's steep at the end, it's steep at the beginning, and it's steep in the middle. There's a few parts where it's not too bad, where you're turning and there's a little bit of a false flat, but the end, the last minute, is cobbles.
And it's the toughest hill of all of them because it's both steep and long. Riders come up here on Suffolk, they turn right on Hazleton, and then what really gets them is the left up there on Burgess, because the last part is cobblestones to finish the hill.
So you have to stand up here and you're throwing your bike side to side and your arms are tired.
All right.
Hey. Yeah, periodically they have these races coming up here and I come out and root for them.
Come on, I got a 20-year-old car. You can beat it.
It's a heartbreaking hill where you might wish there were no cameramen.
It's sad when you can walk up as fast as I ride up. I'd try to lose you, but I'd have a heart attack.
That's all right, don't worry about it. You got it, buddy. You can do it.
You're right there, you got it.
One more hill, excuse me, left.
From the top of the seventh hill, we come down Federal Street to the north side, cross the Clemente Bridge, go through downtown, come across the Smithfield Street Bridge to Station Square, and then from Station Square up Sycamore Street to Mount Washington.
I would say that this is the most famous hill in Pittsburgh for cyclists, and definitely the most famous hill in the Dirty Dozen.
Sycamore Street is famous because back in the 1990s, there was the Thrift Drug Classic professional bike race with which Lance Armstrong won 3 times.
This is a good hill, it's hard. A lot of people want to win it because a lot of people's families meet up with them. It's about halfway through. It's steep at the bottom, mellows out at the top. There's a good switchback in the middle, and I attacked it. The whole hill, the hardest I went was probably right there, that little, I had to switchback right along the curbside there, try to get a gap and try to hold it. A lot of people were here. There must have been a couple dozen cheering, which is really cool.
It's actually not one of the more difficult hills, but it is one of the more scenic with all these backdrops of the city.
I was too young for the Thrift Drug Classic, but I've seen the videos of those guys doing that, and I love that hill and going up to Mount Washington afterwards. We take a big group photo on the overlook, 200 people, all our bikes and stuff. It's really cool. That's a good time.
But these Dirty Dozen cyclists never pause for long. To get from Sycamore, hill number 8, to hill number 9, you have to go from here to Banksville Road, and that means climbing Crane Avenue.
Crane Avenue, if you were in any other part of the country besides Pittsburgh, it would be a raceable hill. It would be one of their Dirty Dozen hills, but for us, it's just in the way. It's a big hill.
Not far off Banksville Road in Beachview, there's notorious hill number 9. Lots of people come here just to watch.
We're on the steepest hill in the world, Canton Avenue.
The hill actually starts off of Banksville Road down there. As soon as you turn left onto Post Avenue, riders are going pretty much all out to be near the front here, because once you make this left turn, the positions don't change much because it's such a short hill.
Canton Avenue, you hope to make it up first try. You don't want to have to do it twice, and it's technically challenging.
And because it's cobblestones, it's very difficult.
The Belgian blocks are a little bit slippery. It doesn't do justice. There's gaps between them on these little tires that are big enough. You feel every one as you're going over them.
It's the steepest hill of them all, at 37%.
And at that grade, it even has a legitimate claim on being the steepest hill in the world.
It's tough. It's tough.
I say try as many times as you want, so I have a food stop on top of the hill because we're here for at least 40 minutes.
Canton Avenue is short, but it's technically hard to get traction if it's wet.
Keep the weight low, don't mash,
You gotta make sure your weight's evenly distributed, because either your back wheel will slip or your front wheel will pop off.
This is a good place to watch crashes.
And you know, Steve-O came in first here, and with these 5 points, he's now won the entire race.
Top of this hill, he had it mathematically won, meaning that if the guy that was in second or third won every hill and Steve-O got 0 points, they still couldn't catch him points-wise.
Yeah, yeah, I won this, and the guy in second place, he fell back, and yeah, mathematic points lost.
Oh, I just can't believe I made it. It was brutal.
Yeah, it's hard. You need to stay to the right and keep your momentum.
My legs are burning, and I'm waiting for some courage.
Stay to the right and keep pedaling.
But it's all a crapshoot, because if the guy in front of you falls, you're done. So,
did you make it up?
I did, on my second try.
Hey, babe. Yeah, I just made it up Canton. I made it the second time up.
Canton's over before you realize you've gone hard. You feel Canton 20 seconds after you finish it. You think, oh boy, that really hurt. And Boosted Canton is actually really hard, because you do Canton and you end up standing around there for a long time waiting for everybody to try to do it. And Boosted hurts because of that.
Boosted is not far away. It's also in Beachview, but we got stuck in traffic. And although we got some pictures of riders at the top of Boosted, we missed them as they struggled to get up its steepness.
I think that's the story of this hill, is that everybody has so much fun on Canton, and they watch Canton, and then they get here and they forget how hard this hill is.
So later, we went back to Boosted with Steve-O and asked him to show us how it's done. It can be a surprise.
And because it's the 10th hill of the day, it's one of the last hills, you're already fatigued in your legs. So it really, it's a hard hill, it hurts.
It's almost as steep as Canton Avenue, but because it's much longer, it's a much tougher hill.
At the top of Boosted, where it intersects Broadway there in Beachview, riders can pause for a moment, and then the pack is off again to the south side slopes.
We used to ride through the Liberty Tunnels, but we no longer do that. We went back up over the hill down to the south side. And the next hill, hill number 11, is Welsh Way on the south side. It goes off of 12th Street.
It's a short sprinter's hill, so positioning is very important at the beginning of the hill, because they don't have a lot of room to pass the other people, you know, for the top five positions. So the crazy thing about this hill is when the riders get up here, there's absolutely nowhere to go except turn around and go back down it.
180 people stand at the top of a hill in the area that's maybe about the size of 4 parked cars, and everybody rides back down the hill.
This is the last short hill of the ride. The last two hills are much longer.
Which brings us to number 12. It's another hill that uses 3 streets to get to the top: Berry, Holt, and Eleanor.
How you get to it is you come off of Josephine Street and come up Berry Street, Holt Street, which is right here, and then this left onto Eleanor Street, which is really a tough finish. It's a long hill. People are really tired by here.
Standing alone, it's one of the hardest hills, probably the second hardest, I would say. And I say that because it gets steep at the end.
Also, the street used to be the big Belgian cobblestones the whole way up.
So unless you pace yourself perfectly, when you're most hurting and most fatigued, you have to try the hardest, and you're probably not able to.
So with blacktop, it's a lot easier of a hill than it was, say, 20 years ago.
Danny Chu warms up at mile 50. So he was nice and warmed up. He was ready to go. Danny told me that he ate several thousand calories on top of Canton Avenue, rested on Boosted, rested on Welsh Way, and won Berry, Holt, Eleanor.
The also wonderful thing about this view is how photogenic it is behind. If you look back, there's an incredible view of the Birmingham Bridge.
That's been some very tough people that started Pittsburgh. I mean, to build on these hills.
I rode with the pack up Berry, Holt, Eleanor, and they're definitely trying in the pack as hard as I'm trying at the front end.
The dozen's over, but because of the baker's dozen, there's one more. The good news for people after this one is that there is only one more.
Riders leave the south side, heading for number 13, by going up another hill and following a long course to Hazelwood on the other side of the Monongahela River. The 13th hill is called Flowers Avenue, Tesla Street.
It goes from Hazelwood down along the Monongahela River and finishes in Greenfield. It goes up, starts on Flowers Avenue, the middle section is Kilbourne Street, and then the left kicker that really gets people is this left onto Tesla.
This is one of the longer hills. It's a gradual run-in from 2nd Avenue, and it gets steeper and steeper and steeper and steeper, and the very steepest part's the end here.
last pitch is 30% and almost 30% grade in places on Tesla Street. But the people know that when they get to the top of that thing, that they've finished the Dirty Dozen. That's a tremendous relief and a sense of accomplishment for all those people that have done it. Yep.
I'm alive, so I think that's an accomplishment in and of itself.
I think I actually won, so that was nice. It was kind of a struggle today, though, not gonna lie.
I had a good time, great time, and, you know.
I did okay. I liked it. It was fun. I didn't like Canton Hill, but everything else was good.
I'll be better shape next year.
Tired. I feel very tired, but I feel great. And I think the number of people and the energy certainly helps. It's one of those unique Pittsburgh things. I think the topography in Pittsburgh is unique, and you could only have this here.
This shows what's awesome about Pittsburgh. We're so lucky to have the roads we have. I couldn't imagine living in Chicago or some other city where it's flat and boring and it's a grid pattern and every road's the same.
When I go to other places that are like way flat, I miss the hills terribly in flat regions, yep.
I think those of us that live here are a little more used to it, but we still struggle.
These roads are all unique. There's no two are the same. No two hills are the same.
It gives you a perspective for what a real hill is.
Thanks for another great year, and see you next year.
Thank you, Ron.
So this ends up the 28th annual Dirty Dozen is finished.
If you want to see other productions from Rick Sebak and his cohorts at WQED, check out the many DVDs offered at shopwqed.org or call 1-800-274-1307.
Ah, you know him. He does all the QED stuff, all the food things of Pittsburgh. You'll know his voice. He's here.
Every Sunday we have.
He does like.
Really?
No, I don't think Rick's riding today. Rick, Colin was wondering if you were riding it today.
I thought about it. Yeah.
If I were you guys, I would maybe go ahead and find spots where you can film on the hills.
We have a second team that.
Oh, you
left.
Do. Oh my goodness, this is serious.
To find out more about these stories, to leave a comment or suggestion, go online to wqed.org/its-pittsburgh. We also have a Facebook page, and on Twitter, follow Rick Around Here. It's Pittsburgh and a Lot of Other Stuff is made possible by the Buell Foundation, serving southwestern Pennsylvania since 1927.